Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Councilman Rory Lancman. I chair the Committee on Courts and Legal Services in the New York City Council. And we appreciate you being here this afternoon to talk about a very, very important issue that affects many New Yorkers and touches on something that is at the core of what we believe New York City is about. And that is the issue of Kuwait Airways denying tickets to Israeli passport holders in violation of both U.S. law and its lease with the Port Authority. Since even before the formal founding of the State of Israel, the Arab world and anti-Semites the world over have tried to strangle the Jewish state militarily, economically, diplomatically. The modern version of this Arab boycott is the so-called boycott divestment sanctions movement, which seeks to demonize Israel and Jews everywhere, in every sphere of human activity, in commerce, in academia, in culture, in politics. Beyond the harm to Israel and the Jews who are affected by these particular boycott BDS actions, the BDS movement is responsible in large degree in the worldwide explosion of anti-Semitism against Jews, Jewish institutions, and Jewish organizations. Kuwait Airways' blatant discrimination against Israeli passport holders combines the twin evils of the traditional Arab boycott and the BDS movement. It's a little background. In 1945, the Arab League boycott against Israel began, and Arab League countries refused to admit Israeli passport holders among many other aspects of the boycott. The boycott banned Israeli products and services and put economic pressure on non-Arab country companies that did business with Israel. In 1977, Congress passed two laws to fine American companies and individuals that cooperate with this boycott. Now, in 2005, the modern BDS movement boycott divestment sanctions against Israel began. It affects commerce. Some of the more spectacular examples, and some people here will no doubt remember Scarlett Johansson, who was a commercial spokesperson for SodaStream, had to step down as an Oxfam ambassador because Oxfam supported the BDS movement. University of California, Riverside, removed Sabra Humus from campus following student protests. Iceland's capital, Reykjavik, voted to boycott Israeli goods. In academia, the American Studies Association voted to boycott Israeli universities. The British Student Union voted to boycott Israeli universities and academic activities. The University of Johannesburg cut ties to Ben-Gurion University in response to pressure from activists. In culture, we see the BDS movement and the boycott movement manifested in the performer Matisyahu having a performance canceled at a concert in Spain because he's not anything to do with Israel. He's just Jewish, because he publicly would not publicly call for the establishment of a Palestinian state. That was such an outrageous example of discrimination that the concert eventually reversed itself. Recently, a Scottish film festival returned money provided by the Israeli embassy to Israeli filmmakers to attend the film festival, and the film that they were going to screen was canceled. And we know in politics the manifestation of the boycott, divestment, sanctions movement with the UN's obsession with Israel. You would think if you went to the UN, like Israel was the only country on earth, the amount of time that they spend demonizing the state of Israel. But even here in the United States, local politics, the Portland Human Rights Commission decided that it would unanimously endorse a ban on the city doing business with companies that do business with Israel, like Caterpillar, Hewlett-Packard, and Motorola. So that brings us to the specific example of the boycott, divestment sanctions movement, the BDS movement, as it relates to Kuwait Airways. Kuwait Airways operates in the United States flying from JFK Airport to London. Now, it operates pursuant to a lease with the Port Authority. This lease with the Port Authority specifically bars discrimination in the provision of services on the grounds of race, color, creed, national origin, or sex. And it specifically provides that the violation of this anti-discrimination provision of the lease is a material breach of the lease and grounds for termination. Furthermore, under U.S. law, the Airline Deregulation Act, foreign carriers are prohibited from subjecting an individual to unreasonable discrimination based on race, color, national origin, religion, sex, or ancestry. Well, Kuwait Airways, as a matter of policy and practice, refuses to sell tickets to Israeli passport holders. Later you'll hear from a gentleman who represents individuals who attempted to buy tickets from Kuwait Airways and were denied the right to do so, the ability to do so, solely because they are holders of Israeli passports. In September 2015, 2 months ago now, the U.S. Department of Transportation formally determined that Kuwait Airways is in violation of federal law, of the anti-discrimination laws that I mentioned. And in a follow-up letter, the Department of Transportation stated that it would have no choice but to take administrative or judicial action against Kuwait Airways if it did not change its policies. We're here today to say that the time for action is now. This hasn't been going on long enough. The Port Authority has been aware of Kuwait Airways' discriminatory practices for a long time now. The U.S. Department of Transportation has already determined that Kuwait Airways is in violation of federal law. We expect that the Port Authority and the Department of Transportation will now act and give Kuwait Airways a very, very simple choice. Either comply with the terms of your lease, comply with federal law, recognize the right of Israeli passport holders to buy tickets on Kuwait Airways, just like people from every other country in the world is allowed to do, or your lease is going to be terminated. You're not going to be able to operate out of JFK Airport. The Department of Transportation will pull your license. You will not be able to operate out of the United States. This is what's fair. This is what's just. And there's absolutely no reason for any further delay. So we're going to hear from some people who have been very, very involved in this issue in many different ways, including a couple of my fellow council members. But next, we're going to hear from Malcolm Honlon, the Executive Vice President of the Conference of Presidents of Major American Jewish Organizations. Malcolm.
Rory gave you much of the information that I would have shared, but we are here not because of a hypothetical concern, but an existing discriminatory policy. While we may not be able to control what governments abroad do, we can't protest practices rooted in bias and restrictions targeting specific populations by entities abroad. When they seek to export their blatantly discriminatory policies to their activities in the United States, then we must speak out and act to ban such practices or prevent those companies from doing business here. The Department of Transportation has made a clear determination. Kuwait is violating U.S. federal law and their lease with the Port Authority. The Conference of Presidents is committed to full enforcement of federal and local anti-boycott legislation to assure the punishment of violators. It's time for Kuwait to make a choice, shape up or no more shipping out. It is especially important when we see the rise of anti-Semitism, when we see the increased number of attacks against Israeli and Jewish individuals, institutions, and businesses, the practice of BDS spreading not only in Europe but even to our own country. It is imperative that we make a stand here and now. We urge the Port Authority to move expeditiously with the Department of Transportation. No more excuses, no more obfuscations. We congratulate all of those who are involved in the Lawfare Project, the members of the City Council. We thank you for your leadership, the members of the Port Authority and former members who have played such an important role, and for all of those who have helped bring this to fruition. This is only step one. This will be an important message. I can tell you in Washington this week, they were talking about it. It sends a message to everyone else who's considering adopting similar practices.
Thank you, Malcolm. Next, we will hear from Brooke Goldstein, who is the director of the Lawfare Project.
Thank you. I want to thank Rory for calling this press conference and for the members of the press that came today. The issue that we're talking about today is a very important one, and that issue is discrimination. It's unlawful ethnic discrimination that has absolutely no place at our nation's airports. Kuwait Airways is the official airline of the country of Kuwait, and it refuses to sell tickets to Israeli nationals. Why? Because they are citizens of a Jewish state. Kuwait, as a member of the Arab League boycott, not only discriminates against Jews, but discriminates against people and companies who sympathize with Jews and against those who do business with the Jewish state. Boycotts of Jewish persons and Jewish businesses is what predicated the Holocaust, and now we see this tactic being used again, targeting Israeli citizens and taking place in our federally funded airports. Former President Jimmy Carter declared this type of grotesque bigotry illegal in our country when he signed the federal anti-boycott laws. Kuwait Airways is not only violating federal law, but they're also operating in violation of the Open Skies Agreement, and they're operating in violation of their lease with Port Authority. Kuwait Airways thinks it can avail itself of the privileges of doing business in our country, in our beloved state of New York, while openly flouting and breaking the law. Talk about arrogance. I commend the DOT's recent decision against Kuwait Airways, finding that the airline engaged in unlawful discrimination against Israeli citizens. It is a crucial first step towards the protection of basic civil rights of persons engaged in air travel from within our country. But this decision in and of itself is not enough. The DOT, as well as the Port Authority, must enforce the decision and must prevent Kuwait Airways from continuing to engage in this deplorable conduct. Effective immediately, I call on the Port Authority to cancel all flights by Kuwait Airways out of JFK until the airline proves that it is operating in compliance with federal and state law. And as a recipient of federal funding, the Port Authority itself must enforce the anti-discrimination provisions of its lease or face liability under Title VI of the Civil Rights Act. All travelers in the United States, regardless of race, ethnicity, gender, or national origin, have the right to be treated equally as they exercise their freedom of movement. This is non-negotiable. This country and our federally funded institutions stand for equal rights and equal protection under the law. And Kuwait Airways must either abide by the rules of our country or it must get out.
Thank you, Brooke. Now I'd like to invite Councilmember Mark Levine, who is the chair of the Jewish Caucus in the City Council.
Thank you, Councilmember Lancman, for pushing this issue, for bringing us together, and for pressuring the Port Authority. Imagine for a moment if an airline prohibited anyone from Ireland from buying a ticket to fly, or if an airline prohibited anyone from Mexico or Turkey from taking one of its flights. There would be an outrage and an uproar. In fact, any action that penalizes people, not for a crime they've committed or a statement they've made or any action they've personally taken, but simply because of the place they were born, is by definition discrimination. And the fact that it's happening in our country, on our soil, in our city, in the five boroughs of New York City, is revolting. Especially against the backdrop of an alarming rate of anti-Semitic attacks here in our city, including two in the last 24 hours in Brooklyn, including the stabbing of an ambulance driver. We just can't stand for this. We know now, based on the federal ruling, that the Port Authority has the legal ability to either to cancel this lease if Kuwaiti Airlines does not correct this egregious behavior. And I'm proud to add my voice to that of the council member and our colleagues in demanding that the Port Authority take action immediately. Thank you.
Thank you, Mark. Next, I want to invite up Jeff Mordler. Jeff is a former commissioner at the Port Authority of New York and New Jersey.
Good morning. I was for 5.5 years a commissioner of the Port Authority until June 30th when my term expired. Port Authority of New York and New Jersey has a long history of doing the right thing. I had an opportunity to see and participate in this during my 5.5 year tenure as a commissioner of the Port Authority. I became aware of the discrimination by Kuwait Airways against Israeli passport holders about 6 months ago when Malcolm Honlein and the Lawfare Project contacted me. I presented the issue to senior Port Authority staff and introduced them to the Lawfare Project representatives so that they could dialogue on this issue. At that time, the Port Authority determined that this was an issue of federal law, and they deferred taking any action pending a determination by the United States Department of Transportation or other federal officials. DOT has now finally determined that the conduct of Kuwait Airways in refusing to allow Israeli passport holders to fly on flights to countries such as the United Kingdom, which do not prohibit their entry, to be discriminatory conduct in violation of U.S. federal law. The Port Authority leases and other agreements with Kuwait Airways prohibit discriminatory conduct, as we've heard today. Last night, at my request, the Port Authority and the operator of Terminal 4 at JFK, where Kuwait Airways leases space, issued a cease and desist notice to Kuwait Airways. If those defaults are repeated in the future or are not timely cured by Kuwait Airways allowing Israeli passport holders in the future to fly to London and other destinations where they will be permitted to enter the country, then their leases and other agreements with the Port Authority should be promptly terminated and their landing rights at JFK Airport revoked. At the same time, I call upon the U.S. Department of Transportation to take similar action to the maximum extent they have enforcement rights. DOT and federal state legislators should also call upon the FAA and any other government agency with jurisdiction over Kuwait Airways to use their enforcement powers to end this discriminatory conduct. This is America. We do not permit discrimination on our soil, and we cannot permit this to continue. Thank you.
Thank you, Jeff. Let me recognize that we've also been joined by Councilmember Helen Rosenthal, Councilmember David Greenfield, and Councilmember Alan Maisel. David, you want to say a few words?
Thank you very much. I want to thank Councilmember Lancman for putting this together. Of course, great to be here with all of my colleagues. I want to thank the Lawfare Project, the Conference of Presidents. You know, I'm just going to expound on Councilmember Levine's remarks. It's not discrimination. It's not simply a matter of nationality. I'm sure that we would have a full plaza here if there was an airline that said that blacks or Hispanics or Asians could not fly on their airline. And it really, it's the same thing. If you discriminated people simply based on the fact of their religion and the fact that they are citizens of the state of Israel, that's no different than discriminating against someone because of their color of their skin or because of their heritage. And so it's really outrageous. And I want to thank everyone for coming together. I reiterate the calls that have been made here today, and I will up the calls and say that I really hope that we'll hear from the governors of our two states, New York and New Jersey, both of whom have a very pro-Israel record, both of whom have a lot of familiarity with the Port Authority, we'll leave it at that, and one of whom is running for president. And so I really would hope to see that they would come out and speak out against what is very clearly anti-Semitic actions by an airline who is trying to do business in the United States. And I think, as Malcolm pointed out, is you have to draw a line in the sand. It's not just about this one airline. It's about sending a message that discrimination, especially when it comes to folks that are being targeted for their religion, is unacceptable. Thank you all very much.
Next, I'm going to ask Jeff Levitky. He's the attorney for Eldad Gat, one of the Israeli nationals who was denied the opportunity to purchase a ticket on Kuwait Airways, to come up and update us.
Thank you. My name is Jeffrey Levitky, and I represent Mr. Gat in the lawsuit that is currently pending before the United States Court of Appeals for the D.C. Circuit. And I would like to read the following brief statement. Kuwait Airways is not excluding Israeli citizens because they want to. Instead, Kuwait Airways is acting at the explicit direction of the government of Kuwait. The Kuwaiti government's embrace of the Arab boycott of Israel is a manifestation of deep hostility towards the Jewish people. We call upon the Congress to make it a crime for any company to boycott Israeli citizens when such boycott is at the direction of a foreign government. And I call upon the Secretary to emphatically reject this manifestation of bigotry against the Jewish people by immediately terminating Kuwait Airways' permit to fly between the United States and the United Kingdom. Thank you.
Alan, do you want to say a few words? Sure. Yeah, Councilman. Many as you want, Bobby. Alan Maisel from Brooklyn.
Thank you, Councilman Lancman, and my colleagues and others. I'm glad to stand with you on this very important issue. Most everything has been said, but I did want to point out that it is an inescapable conclusion that one must make that this situation is caused by anti-Semitism. After all, an individual Israeli does not have responsibility for the actions of its government. And it's clearly, this is an anti-Semitic response. But could you imagine if people would actually take countries to task, like, let's say, Russia, that invades neighboring countries, shoots down airlines, or China that represses its Tibetan citizens and others? Why isn't that there is no worldwide condemnation or worldwide boycott of China or Russia or other countries? Only Israel seems to get this kind of attention. And so, in my mind, I've been studying this issue for a very, very long time, it's anti-Semitism. We in this country stand for other things besides that. We stand for freedom, we stand for fairness, we stand for equality. And to allow this situation to continue is just antithetical to our role as the leading democracy in the world. So I call upon the appropriate parties, like the Port Authority, don't stand behind some illegality which you've created to avoid action. Do something. Thank you.
Thank you. Very good. And last, we'll hear from Professor Richard Stone. He's the former chairman of the Conference of Presidents of Major American Jewish Organizations.
Thank you, Councilman Lancman, and all members of the City Council who have convened this and who have been so supportive. It is for a state-run airline to discriminate explicitly against people carrying Israeli passports is indecent and intolerable. But it's not shocking and incredible. What is shocking and incredible is that that airline has continued to be allowed to fly through United States airports, including in this vicinity where the Port Authority has exercising its powers, hopefully immediately, to stop it, and all over the country. What happens when Kuwait Airlines can fly through American airports, no matter what legalistic arguments have been used, and I'm grateful that the Department of Transportation has come finally to this conclusion. It took prompting. I'm grateful to the Lawfare Project and others, and to the Court of Appeals for the District of Columbia Circuit for helping them reach that conclusion. But I want to say that the message delivered every single minute that Kuwait Airlines is allowed to fly through United States airports is the wrong message. It's a message that the United States does not abhor the BDS movement, and it does. It is totally against American law. It's incredibly against the will of the American people, who abhor this movement and who, if they understood what was going on at their airports, would be very unhappy. The time is today to make the change. Thank you again to the members of the council.
The time is today to make the change, 100%. I just want to mention that we've been joined by Councilmember Steve Levin from Brooklyn. Any questions from any of the members of the press who are here? Very good. Thank you, everyone, and we will keep everyone up to date with what action or inaction the Port Authority and the Department of Transportation takes. Thanks very much.
Rory, I have a question.
Yes, sir.
Is Kuwait?